Yeah, this is really nice. We've talked before in a video about pan-digital numbers. And a pan-digital number was a number that used all the digits 1 to 9. And we had
a
few...
Zero?
It didn't always use zero. I think sometimes we excluded zero and sometimes we included zero. And you get different numbers with different properties. And we had a nice time looking at pan-digital numbers. It does a bit of fun.
It was good.
Yeah.
There it is there. People can click on it.
There?
Yeah, about there.
Yeah.
All right.
Now I want to show you a pan-digital formula. So it's going to be a formula that uses all the digits 1 to 9. And it's really nice, actually. Let me write down the formula. 1 plus 9 to the power, so I'm going to use minus 4 to the power 6 times 7. That's all in a bracket. And then I take that to a power, which is going to be 3 to the power 2, which is the power to 85. So this is the formula. Now let's just check it's a pan-digital formula. Let's check all the digits are there. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes, I've used all the digits 1 to 9, but what's so special about that formula? It's really cute. This formula is equal to 2.718281828459. This formula is actually E. It's approximately E. How approximately though, how good is it? This is correct to 18 trillion digits.
No.
Decimal places.
Go away.
Yeah, I know, it's great. This lovely little formula is incredibly accurate for E. It's beautiful. I'll tell you how that happened. So this formula, it's not a very old one. It was found in 2004 by a guy called Richard Sabe, and he did something very clever to get this formula. Because the definition of E, it's the limit as n tends to infinity of 1 plus 1 over n to power n. Now he did something clever. He found a number, which I'm going to call capital N. It's going to be a big number. Actually, I'm going to let it be this thing we've got here, this power. So he had a number, 3, to the power 2 to the power 85. And then he did this clever thing. I'm just going to mess around with this a little bit. I hope you're happy with how powers work, because I'm going to use some properties of how powers work. And this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to take one of these 85 here, and I'm going to use it to square the 3. So it becomes 9 now. To the power 2 to the power 84. And now I'm going to do another clever thing. If you're happy with how powers work, this is also equal to 9. I'm going to double the 2 there, so it becomes a 4. And 84 gets halved, so it becomes a 42. This is all properties of powers. And I'm going to split up the 42. This becomes 9 to the power 4 to the power 6 times 7, because that's 42. If I stick a minus sign in there, it will become 1 over n. So what he's got now is a formula in this shape. 1 plus 1 over n to the power n. But this n is massive. This is a massive number. It's so big that it makes an incredibly accurate approximation of E. It's not infinity, it's not tending off to infinity and being E exactly. It's big enough to make something that is correct to 18 trillion digits. There was a challenge. It was like some sort of challenge on the internet. As a challenge, he went, let me think about this. For the same competition, he actually came up with a few formulas, and he was going through all the classic mathematical constants. So he did E, and E is the best one. And I love E so much. But he also did pi and others. The pi one I'll show you, I don't like it as much. I don't think it's as good. It's clever that he's done it with a pan-digital formula, but I'll show you why it's not so good. So he's got a formula for pi, and it's going to be approximately equal to, and this is it, it's going to be 2 to the power 5 to the power 0.4 minus 0.6 minus, and in brackets here, we've got 0.3 to the power 9 over 7. And then to take that bracket, we're going to take it to the power 0.8 to the power 0.1.
Yeah, lots of points.
Lots of points, and instead of saying 0.6 and 0.1, he's used point. So he's cheating, maybe, I don't know, by not using the zeros. I'm not as satisfied with it. This is accurate to pi up to 10 decimal places. It's a lot less impressive. So you've got a pan-digital formula for pi for 10 decimal places with a bit of a cheat. I don't know, depends on how you feel about that, using point instead of 0 point something. I don't like that formula as much. And then there's a number that can be divided by 10 as well. And that's also unique. So that would be a unique pan-digital number, including zero.